Assalamu alaikum friends, my name is Muhammad Yunus and I am Odoo technical developer. As you guys know that we are working on developing a module in order to prepare an Odoo 13 technical course. So for this purpose we have developed this Open Academy module and we have added a lot of feature in this module. So if you don't know about our technical course, so you can go to YouTube and search for Odoo discussions channel, and you can find all these videos here on this channel. So please take a second and subscribe to our channel and click the bell icons to get the updates of the upcoming videos. Here in the playlist you can find this playlist where we grouped the video for your ease. So let me go to our topic for today. So for today I am going to discuss how we can upload this module to Odoo App Store like the other apps that are available, but this will be available for free. In another video I will discuss how to upload a paid module. So there is just a little bit of difference in the process, so I will differentiate between these two process. So before going to upload this module, we have to keep in mind two things, that we should have an account on odoo.com, and we need to create also account on GitHub. So GitHub is not mandatory, but for, in place of GitHub you can use GitLab also, but GitHub is very popular and you can use GitHub, and in this video I am going to use GitHub. So on the odoo.com portal you will have to create your account. You can sign in here if you already have an account. If you don't have an account, you can just click here don't have an account to create your own account. And I already have an account, so I am just going to log into my account, and here you will have these options. Here I have to go to my apps dashboard. So here you will be able to see all the apps that have been sorted out, and you will see your apps performance. So and then you will have to click here on repository, and then for uploading a new module to Odoo App Store, just click this button, and then it will, you will be redirected here to this screen. So here you will have to add the link of the module here that is located on the GitHub. So for this purpose, first you will have to upload it to the GitHub, and I will tell you how you can create a GitHub repository and how you can upload your module to GitHub. So here are some of the guidelines that you can read about it. These are the different FAQs. You must need to read it before uploading your module. And here one thing I want to mention here, that if you don't, these are the some mandatory things that you need to add: how to set up icon, cover image and description. These things need to set up before uploading your module to to Odoo App Store. So for this purpose, these all things has been mentioned here, that you will have to add the icon here in this directory, and then the cover image should needs to be added in this format, and then you will have to add index.html file in order to add the description of the module in detail, and you can add different images inside this index.html file. So if you don't know what is the format for this file, you can just click here and open this format, and you can use this official format. So let me add these things. First of all, we will have to add the icon in our module. So let me go here and then go to index, and here inside the index, so let me first check, it should be inside static description icon.png. So if these folders have not already been created, then you will have to create it inside your module. Create static, and then description, and then what is it, description, and then your icon. So let me create another directory with the name description, and then inside description we will have to add the icon. So what icon we want to add here, so let me go to our desktop and then copy this file image. Let me paste in our Odoo directory, Odoo 13, and then inside Odoo 13 it is Odoo discussion, and then Open Academy, and then static description and then paste it here. So the name of the file should be icon. So one thing you need to keep in mind that the icon should be in PNG format, as it is in JPG format. So this will not work in this case. So let me go to Odoo discussions and then go to logo, and here we can see this is in PNG format. So let me copy it from here and then go to Odoo and then Odoo 13 and then Odoo discussions and then description, and let me delete this one and then paste it. So here we will have to change its name to icon.png. So the format, the image should be in PNG format, otherwise this will not work. So let me restart the Odoo service. So let me open the browser and then here go to apps, Odoo apps, and here let me upgrade the module. So let me open it first and then click the upgrade button to upgrade the module. So after the module upgrade, we will be able to see that the icon has been added for this module. So the module has been upgraded successfully. Let me go to apps and then let's see. So here we can see that the icon has been updated for this module. So this is the first thing that we have done, and then we will have to add the images here. So we will use this format, like in the manifest file we will have to add this index. So let me go to Open Academy manifest file, and then at the end let me add this one, like this one, and then add this at the end. So what should be the images format? Like in the folder, the cover image thumbnail location is defined as images, and the key for, like, so it depends on the location where you have added. So you can add a separate folder for this to add the images, but or we don't want to add a separate image, we want to add the same image that we have here. So let me copy the path. So let me copy the path for this one like this, and then add it here like this, and let me remove this Open Academy because it is exactly under the static description and then icon.png. And after that we will see the cover image when we upload this module to the Odoo app store. And then the next thing is to add the index.html file in order to add the description. So let me go here, and then I will have to copy it from here. So copy everything from here and then just paste in our index.html file. So where we need to place this index.html file, so it should be in static description and index.html. So let me add inside the description directory, and then it should be index.html, and then paste the whole stuff here. So this is the standard format code that has been added by Odoo, and you can use this to add your code. So let me just remove all this section. I just want to add this one section, like this one. So I want to add just this one section, like just to show you how it has been added. Here we will add Odoo 13 technical course, Odoo 13 technical course, and then here we will add here you can learn all about Odoo 13.0 development. So like this, and then you can add a screenshot here like this. So let me add the image name like this one and this one. So this is it. We have added this, and let me show you the Open Academy module how it looks like. So it looks like this, and then let me restart Odoo service and then upgrade the module. So after the module update, you will be able to see the change, and a description will be added below here. So the module has been upgraded successfully. Let me go to apps again, and then let me open this module, and here you can see that the description has been added. You can see Udo 13 technical course, and here you can learn all about Udo 13 development. So here the image looks ugly and it is really big, so let me add some styling for this. We can add we can add here height equal to like 500 pixel, and then width is equal to 100 pixels. We can add something like this and then save this file, and then refresh the module. So the module refreshed and you can see the image is now looks better. So you can add some other HTML styling, and you can also apply CSS and your own styling. So this is it. This is the third step that we have added, and then you will have to add the license. So if you will have to read in detail about the license policies, there are different type of licenses. So if you don't add any license, then Udo by default would add this LPGL version 3 license. So you don't need to worry about it, but you can read about it in detail. So the next step is to create the GitHub repository. So for creating a GitHub repository, you will have to create first the GitHub account. So go to github.com, and then if you are logged out, you will have to create your account. If you have an account, then you will have to enter your login passwords in order to log in to your account, and then click this new button to create your new repository. So here you can add the name, and then you can add some description, and then you will have to keep it as private if your module is free, and if it is paid module, then you will have to keep it as private. But we are going to make it as public because this is a free module and everyone should be able to download it. And here readme file, and then you will have, after entering the name, you can create it like this. You will be able to create the repository. So as I have already created the repository with the name Udo discussions, so let me open the directory here. So here you will have to add the branch for which you have developed this module, and you want to upload it for the versions. As you know that I have developed this Open Academy module for version 13, so I will have to add another branch with the name 13.0, and it is really simple to add a new branch in GitHub. So you just need to click on this master branch and then add here the branch name, which should be unique, and you can click here on this create branch to create the new branch. So it will create the new branch, and all the modules that are available on the master will be moved to the new branch. So here now we will have to register your GitHub repository by adding the link here. So the link should be in this format like this one. Let me copy it from here and then paste it. So it is like SSH GitHub at the rate of this, and then auto, and then auto.com. So here you will have to add the name of your repository, so which is Udo discussions, and then let me add it like this, and we can also copy it from here like this, github.com, and let me paste it here like this one. And then here we need to add the branch number, like it has been added 13.0 13.0. And then we need to click the submit button to register the repository. So let me click here the register button. So here the GitHub repository has been added here, and then we can see that if this is if you want to publish it, and we need to click it. But before that, we will have to click the scan button to scan all the modules that are available in this. So we will get an error message. So we got an error message that module excellence persistence belongs to another repository. As this is another, as this is a community module, so therefore we cannot upload this module to our repository. So for this, we will have to remove this module, and then we can upload it again. So let me delete it from here and then push the code again. So git add git commit. Module is 13 point. So as we have made the changes in master branch, so let me push this to master branch, and then I have to push it to the other branch. So let me switch my branch to 13.0. let me first pull it and then git checkout 13.0. so I have, let me check the status, and here it is the status. So let me delete the module, and this is the module, and so we will have to as the module that was already uploaded was not the updated one, and we have added the changes inside the module after creating the branch. So we will have to pull a master branch in order to update the changes in this one also. Git pull origin master, and then we will have to push it into 13.0. So this is how you can pull and push the code to GitHub. And let me rescan this again. So if you check the repository, we can see, let me refresh it. So we can see that our report excellence module has been removed, and only Open Academy module is available. So module dependencies are exist for another series. Please select every module or use the right. So this error shows that this module already exists on the Odoo App Store, and we will have to change our module name. So if we search on the Odoo apps, so we can see that this module is available with the name Open Academy, and we cannot upload it again. So we will have to change its name, like the technical name, and let me just change its technical name, and we can edit it like refactor, and then it should be OD, like OD discussion, and then Open Academy. So let me change it, and it is not working right here. So let me open it here, and then let me change it OD and then underscore. So it has been changed. Let me close this window, and then you can see it has been changed to Odoo disk directory, Open Academy. So we will have to change the references for this module everywhere. So let me search for Odoo discussions, sorry, for Open Academy. You can see the Open Academy is used everywhere, so you will have to change it everywhere, otherwise you will get an error message. So I will just change it, and I will upload it again, and here let me just show you how it works. So let me upload this module to GitHub, git add, and then git commit, and then name changed, and git push origin 13.0, 13.0 is the branch name. So let me go here to the apps, and then let me click the scan button to scan it again. So here we got another message, the license conflict with our dependency. Please make sure you comply with the license that is maintained here. May already exist for another series, please. So we are getting two error message that the license has not been added, and the second one is this one, which is not yet resolved. So let me get go here and let me copy the license keyword from here, and then let me paste it. So here we need to edit like this, and then it comma at the end. This is it. We have added it like this, and then let me push the code, get it. So if we see here, we can see this changes has not been added to the GitHub repository. So if we go here, so we can see there are no two modules. One is Open Academy, and the other one is Open Academy. And here we got a message that this module is already available on Odoo App Store. So we will have to remove this one. So in order to delete it from here, so click this one, and then you will have to click here and then delete the directory. So this will show you the difference, and then you can go at the end and adjust right here, like delete directory. It is fine. Commit directory to V13. So commit the changes. So it will be deleted, and here you can see only one module. So let me go here and then rescan it. So here we can see only we have the error of the license. So let me hit license changes, git commit changes, git push 13.0. We got an error message that we have conflicts. So let me first pull the changes from 13, and here it has been pulled, and then let me push the changes again. So here it is. Now the repository is fine, and then let me go to apps and scan this again. So hopefully this will work fine this time. So here we can see a success message. So let me check this option and then click this settings menu, and then click the publish all apps from this repo. So this button will publish all the apps that are available in this repository. So it has been published. So let me go to the apps. So let me click here to open this app, and so here you can see this module has been uploaded to GitHub, and it has been developed by Git Auto Discussions. So this module is officially uploaded to App Store and it's available for free. So you can download it from here, and you can watch our YouTube channel to learn Odoo step by step. So let me just change the title of the module, like this name. So it should be like Odoo 13.0 Technical Course. So let me push this change, git add, git commit, name change, git push. 13.0 is the branch name. So in order to take effect of these changes, we will have to go back to this, and then we will have to rescan it again, and then just click this button, and then go to apps, and here you will be able to see Odoo 13 technical course. So let me try open it, and here you can see the title has been changed to Odoo 13 technical course. If you want to unpublish it, you can just click this button to unpublish it. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, please give a huge thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, so please go and subscribe to our YouTube channel and learn about Odoo. Thank you.